to help you. Really, but to give you ideas, our big focus was, you have multiple things going on, so this will allow you to plan ahead, to put things together when you have time available.
But to be very honest, I do 10 times those posts just to keep the algorithm going, and there's not a lot of content there. And there's not, like the Saltwise week, I had planned 6 days out before, like 4 days before Saltwise week came up. Then we got that post, it blew up, Bill caught it right as it blew up. I scrapped every post I had created and then went into education so that it didn't become a topic in the community. We had to scrap it. So I am prepared, I am making posts in advance and doing stuff with the other graphs and shared posts, because I'm not going to take the liability of becoming a meteorologist when I'm not a meteorologist. That's not a good idea. So the liability is that post was made by the Department of Transportation, that was made by the US Weather Service. It's a completely not biased source. This is what they're saying you should do, you go. There's no liability involved. And I think that's the best choice. So yes, it is a lot of shared posts, and it's a lot of shared posts from around town, but there's also original content. And I'm making sure to keep that going. Shared posts cannot be on ahead of time. Original content.
So that's, yeah, and that was kind of the intent, you know, and I think one of the things on there was like the various parks. Like it had a nice resource there of all the parks, and if we could create something, you know, really talk about it with people, because we found parks that we weren't aware of as good endeavors. So that was the idea, to help give you ideas. Certainly there's gonna be, you know, other content that you share, but this is, the intent was to be something for you as well, but to have them as a record.
If it's something that you're printing out in your advance, it would just be easier to give it to me on paper and say, here you go, here's the ideas, instead of having to constantly check in the working document to see if something's changed.
So, but life isn't like that. Sometimes things come up with the town that we want to share, but so it's not
going to share.
So we would, no, I'm just saying a topic comes up and we feel like we want the community to know about it. So we would put it in this document that you would then see it, and then we're prepping it, we're helping you with it. Hey, could you post this next Tuesday about a park?
Or how often am I expected to check this document, and how do I know that things are added? Because I don't use that for that. The only time I've ever used that as a resource to use Google Docs is to put things on that screen for the trash audit. And it's not a working document that I have to check. I add and subtract as needed, and I walk away.
So how do we communicate with you when we want to share something that we feel would be important?
I guess that's my question, is how do I know that you added it?
No, I'm asking you, what is the most convenient way?
We've indicated that direct emails from all of us is not helpful. So if they're not helpful and Google Docs is not the correct way, how do we communicate? I think that's
I would think through Michelle would be the communication.
So we would channel to Michelle, and then Michelle would send you an email to then say, this is what we'd like you to communicate.
Okay,
I just wanted to know. So you're gonna check your emails, because—
Yeah, they get checked constantly, but like, I don't know, that's what my question is. I'm not using Google Docs. I don't know if an alert comes up. I don't know where it shows me that you added something. Like, I don't know how Google Docs works. I've expressed that several times, and I don't know, does it?
It's, depending on how you set it up, it does send you my email when there's an update to the document. And it'll say, so-and-so has edited.
Right, so I've never gotten an email like that, or an email you
I don't know that we've edited since last year.
Yeah. No, since it was presented.
Yeah,
I think Jen had last added a bunch of stuff.
And I'm sure that wasn't what you were looking for, so that's what you're doing. And if that's not what you wanted on the document, that wasn't my edit. So I just.
Oh, I don't remember saying it wasn't one that we wanted. I was just saying, no, that was something that we hadn't seen or didn't have.
You said that wasn't the direction we were going with it, and that wasn't what you were looking for. It was the direct quote. And so I took it off because I wasn't going to change the document that you guys were prepared to do separate. And if that's your tool, I'm not going to change it. I'm
Okay, so we definitely said it was a working document to be shared and look for your input as well. That was why the tool was chosen, but apparently that's not.
It's like shared drive, it's no different than that. So instead of having 15 emails with 15 different copies, but you gotta figure out which one's up to date, it's a shared drive and everybody can access that document at any time, and at that point in time, it's up to date. And it does say who edited, so you know who made a change at some point. It's just a tool, it's a tool that everybody uses.
In the ad hoc committee as well.
It doesn't work.
And that's why when you started it, I had asked and stated that I didn't understand it, and so if you know how to do it, tell me what to do, it just kind of sat there. I figured out how to edit, so I asked the kids and they added and then took it off and then I kind of ended up doing it.
Yeah, I wasn't a part of it afterwards, but when Michelle knows how to use it, then I'm sure she would help you and do the best.
Sure.
Well, I don't necessarily think that the social media calendar needs to be taken super literally. I think the intent when we got the idea to put it together was a tool to spark creativity for you. Like, I personally speaking, I know I can sit there and struggle with what to post on social, and all it takes is somebody to give me an idea, and then I'm off and running, and then I'm good with it. But sometimes it just takes a little bit of, oh, those are good ideas, and then you can expand on that. I think that was really the intention of it, not so much as, you know, this is a line, we need an exact, you know, we're looking for an exact post on this, we're looking for an exact post on this. It's really just ideas for creativity. Since we hadn't had Facebook before, and we were starting from nothing, the goal being, okay, we can make this going, we can generate ideas, these ideas can be repurposed year after year, and then if they're at least documented somehow, should at some point that task get delegated to someone other than you, there's a good history built up. It's okay, this is how we do it, this is what we post about, this is generally what we post about at certain times of the year. It makes it that much easier for the next person, but I don't think the intent ever was, you know, post these things specifically.
I just don't think that we really discussed it, which is kind of here it is, and so I didn't understand it, and there's that, so.
So I think that makes a lot of sense. I guess I didn't know that. That makes a lot of sense.
Can I make a motion that she gives admin rights to you?
I wish I knew how to do that. If she comes on my computer, does she want to?
So you gave us admin rights to the folder, you would?
I had the kids talk me through it while I was doing it.
Okay.
I seriously don't know how to use it.
Okay.
And that's why the first time you go correctly, because I thought I was in the folder here, and I wasn't in the folder. I don't use Google Docs at all. I stated that from the very beginning, that I had no idea how to use the program.
So then how do we resolve?
You put it in the laptop to Michelle, and Michelle will help me here on Saturday, she can come up and change the version.
So it's 3 seconds to, yeah, they voted on and discussed. I'm not, what is the motion again?
To give Michelle admin rights for Google Docs. That's obviously, it doesn't belong there, so we'll move it somewhere where it can.
Any discussion? Do we want to, okay, since that isn't software that you're comfortable with, Jen, would it be better for us to move it to something different, like just a plain old Excel sheet or something?
I copied and pasted and put it on to a Word document, so I just have what I need to add for the different holidays and stuff like that. There are a lot of resources out there that allow me for it to move a sheet or like anything other than to spark your imagination and say this stuff.
Yeah.
It's unbelievable. But, you know, to pick and choose kind of the things that's relevant and then put them on there, so halfway through there, you know, I just in case more, and I've been putting all of the posts into folders I have a Word document with the holidays, and then the files are held in the communications committee folder on my computer, so it's just there, and it says website, and then, or I mean, Facebook, and it's there, and then the website one's actually the website. If you go into the dashboard, it actually has a media file for every picture you've ever posted. So every picture that's ever touched that website is in this repository that's like hundreds of pages. So you can just choose to reselect a comp media file instead of even having to go off of the desktop.
Well, it's, I mean, it sounds to me like you've taken what we have given you and run with it. Do we even need to do a shared document anymore this week? I mean, if you've already taken it and expanded on it, and it's in a format that's shareable, should the task go to somebody else, do you?
Just like with another stuff, but.
Yeah, I guess I don't know that we even need to do a shared calendar anymore, if you've already expanded on it. I mean, it sounds really thorough.
I try to make it so that if I get by a boss tomorrow, anybody can walk in the office and do my job in any aspect of the job, because that was not what I walked into, and I didn't want to do it to somebody else. So whether it be court or anything else, takes them 5 minutes to look at a full sheet, know what to do, my drafts are there, everything is ready to do. You could walk in my office tomorrow and not even do it, with a little
I think that's great.
So, I think that's just how we work, and Jean has done pretty much the same thing with her job, because she felt the same way. So it's just been, thanks for doing that.
Yes.
Because it wasn't the best thing, so that you understand, because I mean, who's to say it, I don't get sick.
Right.
And then the judge walks in and has to do my job, which he had to do in the past, and it wasn't a good experience for him, and I don't think that's fair either. So, there's a lot of different ways that I try to make it really.
So the purpose of Google Docs, since we don't all sit in an office with a cubicle right next to each other, it was to communicate without having 15 emails. Is there no need for it anymore? Is that what I'm hearing, or when we're doing these reports?
I think we can use it for the committee. I just don't think that we need to have Jennifer a bit for the social media campaign. It sounds like she's taken that and run with it. I've not seen me, because I'm just suggesting we take that part of it out of the picture. Especially since she's not comfortable with Google Docs, it's just sort of.
So we still get her admin rights, and then we'll just keep it.
Right, because it's a whole folder that we all were created, right? Yeah.
We'll just have to figure out how to get the card.
High school kids.
Yeah.
They'll see things all the time. I don't know, my daughter does it.
Okay, so, yep, and then.
Jen, if you want to.
Any further discussion on the Google?
Would somebody else, like me or a citizen, come to you, five of you or one of you, and say, I've got a great idea for August, a topic, how would they get that on your agenda?
I would say either, you know, through an email, like communications, yeah, chairperson or any board member, or yeah, council meetings are posted, or.
So now I got 4,020 potential fees to you to for topics on the website.
Yeah.
Because right now you've got five people tied into Google Docs.
Right.
I think you're missing the point of what Google Docs is for. It's a shared drive. That's it.
Okay.
It's not a vehicle through which we communicate with the community. Something that we can share docs and updates without duplicating effort if there's something that we're trying to write. So I'm not sure how that would go through Google Docs if somebody's going to send something in.
Who would they send?
Well, I know on the last newsletter Michelle had a little down on the bottom to contact her. That's one.
Yeah,
one letter.
That's
my
email.
Makes
sense.
All right, we have a motion to move the admin rights of the shared folder from Jen to myself and a second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed?
Michelle, can I correct what I thought I heard? Because Mary Jo asked, how would we get information to Jim? And the response was, talk to Michelle, and Michelle will talk to Jim. I think that's incorrect.
That's what the board told us at the February meeting.
Yeah, I think the process is for, because Jim is the court, Jim is the planning commission, and Jim has 20% of the time dedicated to this. Consequently, I thought the chain was, you as the liaison, you go to her supervisor, Kim, to see if what you need can be delegated or done. And if it was a policy or a board or a fiscal matter, the request would go to the board, because that's the case, those decisions.
That's what was discussed in February meeting?
Yeah.
I wasn't there, so I'm asking.
I think that's.
Well, I haven't heard that, so.
I just heard that all things have to follow.
From the communications committee.
To Michelle.
So then Jim would only give things from me, as opposed to other members of the committee, was the distinction in February. Maybe we should.
Yeah, because her supervisor is Kim. And Kim.
But she's not.
She's our.
Yeah, she's the Facebook.
There's three webmasters, Jean, Kim, and Michelle. So collectively, any idea you have that you're funneling through Michelle has to be evaluated by the webmasters. It probably will be done by that webmaster.
Do Jean and Kim do the website?
They upload agendas and.
That they have, right, they're going to do it, but you pretty much can contact everything, right? I mean, see what.
Kim's direction.
Right, but I have.
You don't ask Kim for every single thing you post, do you?
We have to publish everything, yeah.
So you ask anything you.
Yeah, I have to. Yeah, if it's weather related and at 6 in the morning, I don't bother her. But if it's a created document that's not a share, I don't, we all edit each other. We edit all our minutes for each other.
That's not problematic for you, is it, to go to Kim and say, we have work that needs to be done, can Jim do it?
I guess, yeah, I already understand that there is still clarity needed. I know we had another discussion at one of our town board meetings. I will be putting it on the agenda again in March for the expectations of this communications committee. And that would be included in understanding the flow, because clearly there are still issues and ambiguity that needs clarification.
It's great. So I don't know that, I don't know what the correct answer is to that question.
Yeah, I was just saying, if something just came up real quick, like, wow, we should really get this communication out, let people know. I just want to know that Jim.
It's a suggestion.
It's just a suggestion. You know, and it's relevant, it's not something 2 weeks from now, it's something in the next few days.
Think if it's an emergency is what it is.
Well, it's not an emergency like that.
When you mentioned the salt awareness, you came to me and asked about that being posted. And I shared that with Jim and copied it to him, and I did call, yes, for sure.
So with that in my mind, I'm thinking, I can't tell her what to do. You gotta go through a process. Can't you do it? Is it relevant? Should it be done?
See, I disagree.
I think we had, yeah, that was a discussion at one of the board meetings when we talked about the expectations. And obviously, it still needs clarity around, just because not every, I think, made it quite clear in that discussion at the board meeting that not everything that Jen's going to post is going to be reviewed by a board member before it's posted.
Because that would definitely like the process.
Right.
My other thought, though, is if it's communicated through an email, I don't get my email that night.
No, that's never expected.
That's never expected.
So if it's something like that needs to be posted.
I'm not not saying that.
There has to be another way to get it to me, so that I know that, because I wouldn't know on a Saturday to go ahead and post something. And I do bring that so that I can, because like I got with the storms, like that was important, that I needed it out there. You know, the PD, if there's a branch down in a road or a live wire, they let me know when I get out there.
That would come from us, right?
You know what I'm saying, but that's something that that information is coming across, so I don't know if there's a better flow, but at this point, it's kind of tricky.
And can I respond to a comment Bill made? Even the military distributes command and control, first autonomy given to different people in the chain. There is a chain, and if we're gonna force everything down a specific chain all the time, we're gonna get killed in a war. When you have commandos in the field, they make, I have autonomy to make decisions, needed decisions there. And I would hope in this town, we have some autonomy given the few people we have. So as primary webmaster, you have autonomy. You know when you need to ask a question, and that's just common sense, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you go to Kim and get feedback. Otherwise, you move forward pretty much, right? I mean, isn't that how it works?
Something bigger, it feels like it would be
right.
Controversial, and then it runs high repetition.
Yeah. So I think I don't want that everything has to go through Kim, and I guess I would think that would need to be clarified, because that just sounds very bureaucratic and not moving things along very fast. It just seems crazy. There should be at least some definition of what you've got autonomy for, and then you can handle those. And then when it's not being able to be handled by you, you can elevate it to Kim, or if the suggestion is that you gotta go to Kim, I would think you would elevate it. It's not fitting in here. And you can have
obviously not looking for all of you.
No, right. And even if your email is directed to Jen at CC to Kim, she's aware of it.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know, I'm just trying to be expedient.
Well, and that is an easy situation with many, many bosses.
I do select them.
Yeah.
So.
All right. So thank you, Jen. I think that covers the videos and the social media plan.
Appreciate the dialogue.
This was very helpful. Another interesting topic from the February board meeting, and I felt some of the discussion around the mission vision logo kind of went in a circle. I think Bill made the case that, yep, he has some consultants that the board, all of the board members should come with suggestions. But then at one point, I thought I heard Joe or maybe even Jim Mills say, well, Michelle, Communications Committee, you know, should finish on their recommendations, or I don't remember exactly how it was worded, what needed to be done. So again, I think this is an area that is lacking clarity. Barb, what's your expectation?
I believe that the board took a vote, and the vote was 4-0 to hire a consultant to walk the town board through mission, vision, and strategic plan. I thought
we had to first determine if we had a board.
Right.
I
remember that.
And we don't have a budget. But we had to get a budget before we could do that. So
that was kind of the circle that we were in.
The vote was heading down that path, but then it was said, well, if you don't have a budget, how can you vote on that?
And so then I think it was come back with consultants.
Yeah.
The item included a fiscal note seeking funds, probably from ARPA and caregiver. And it's a motion that's been passed.
Yeah.
Okay, so I think that's okay.
Okay.
Now, I haven't seen the draft of Jean from the minutes. I believe there was also a 3-1 vote to schedule a special meeting to discuss the parameters of the motion. But the motion's been passed.
So what restricts the public from submitting their own letter? Their suggestions on how to go about it. Nothing does, right? So the committee, I don't understand. The committee is just talking through this. I'm fundamentally not understanding this. There are thoughts and suggestions, purely advisory. I think this committee is advisory, right? We don't.
Correct.
So that would be an advisory report. What keeps us from having an advisory report about anything we want to discuss as a committee? I don't understand that.
I think one of the recommendations from the ad hoc committee was input from the communication committee, which wasn't formed at that point, but that they would have input.
Right.
On branding, logos, vision, mission. I think that was one of the recommendations.
And that's why we had it on our agenda, but then, like I said, sometimes it just goes shut down, and other times it's not clear. So my
policy group, Michelle, I did a background, I did analysis, I did recommendations,
and that
motion went to pass. There's still a fiscal concern. Frankly, I believe there are funds to entertain a consultant for a short-term project to come up with some sort of vision, mission, strategic plan that the community can react to. Could they react at the April annual meeting? Could they do it through survey? Could they do it for focus groups? But we just want to get this done.
Right.
Or determine if it's needed based on some of our research.
It's another option. I believe I gave that. So, not required, but I have to do it.
So I made a note that, you know, the sub-comment on the agenda was to schedule a special town board meeting if needed for further discussion on the vision, mission, and strategic plan. And I made a note that if this is going to be added to the March board meeting agenda, whether or not we will schedule a special meeting.
But I guess I still have a question. Why can't the committee come up with an advisory report? What's wrong with that?
I think that's what that ad hoc.
What was the consultant?
So that's what we were working on. So
mm-hmm.
Let everybody get their own in the bucket. I just don't understand. So we'll just continue doing that. Is that what we're thinking? Just wrap up your thoughts.
Until the March meeting.
Or at least table it until next Monday and see if we can brief the minutes and come up with a more definitive direction.
Mm-hmm. Is that a motion to do?
I move that we table the mission, vision, logo discussion until.
March 6th is the board meeting?
No,
it's
our meeting.
Our meeting.